Alright, Makeup Geeks, I have a personal update for you guys. I just wanted to tape that to stay in touch. I will be totally honest, I have so much on my plate right now trying to launch an enormous line of products for 2015. I have a lot of traveling going on, which I'll tell you about in a second. So I still want to do videos every Monday and Friday, but I may not be able to do quite as many tutorials because that takes a lot longer to tape. I'm just being very honest with you guys, but I still want to tape videos for you. So please always give me feedback. Comment in the YouTube box of what you would like to see, because I have to be very particular in what I tape now just because I don't have as much time anymore. But I still wanted to give you a personal update to let you know what's going on with Makeup Geek, because there's a ton of stuff happening. So basically, you guys know we're opening a store in Sacramento because that's where I live now, and it will open next year. I know we were trying to get open in December. Long story short, we had a couple buildings we were looking at. One of them just didn't fit for us. We'd have to do a lot of work to make it ready. So we found another building that's actually a lot better. It's bigger for us. We have complete offices for all the staff. We have the retail store up front. It's amazing, you guys. It's going to be so cool. We'll have this big conference room where I get to teach classes. We'll have PlayStation so you guys could come in and just chill and hang out and have fun with the makeup and all of that. I'm so excited. So we're hoping that's going to open next March or April, depending on how long construction takes. So I'm going to sign the final papers for that next week, and then we'll get started on the design and construction on it to make it ready for you guys. So fingers crossed everything goes through. That will be open next year. And then also I'm working on a ton of products, you guys. Next year I'm going to launch probably new products every at least month or couple months. We have eyeliners that have already set in. Those will be coming in early next year. I'm working now on lipsticks, lip glosses, lip stains, concealers, foundations, pressed powders, contour powders, and highlighters. Woo! Yes, it's a lot. I did a lot of work this year. That's why I'm saying when I have a hard time taping, that's why, because I'm really pushing hard to get as much product out for you guys. And it is more work when you do it very custom like the way I'm doing it. I want to make sure every single color of every product that I approve. So it does take a lot of time and a lot of work on my end. So anyways, I want to show you guys the lipstick packaging so you guys can tell me again in the YouTube box which packaging you guys would like to see. And let me try to hide the labels on here. But okay, so lipsticks is gonna be the first thing. You guys can have either the traditional like this, it's called the bullet, where it has the pointed tip. And at first I was like, yeah, I kind of want that too, but so many companies have that now. I want something a little bit different. So what I'm pushing for, but it's up to you guys, is the slim line. Let me show you this packaging. It's like a really thin slim line, so it's really cool because it's sleek. It has like the nice slim tube. It's easy to hold in your purse. It doesn't take up a lot of room. But look at the shape of this. It perfectly fits your lips. I love how this works. At first I was like, oh, I don't know if I like it, but once I started playing with it, I like this a lot. Oh, which by the way, Vampy lipstick. What I'm wearing today is Max Living Legend. At first I was like, ooh, I'm too pasty to wear this lip color, but I actually like it. I think it pops a lot. They're a little dry, so if they look patchy, that's why I'm like rocking the dry lips today. But anyways, you guys decide, do you want the traditional lipstick like this, or do you want the slim line? So whatever you guys decide is the packaging that I'm going to go with. So you can tell me in the comments below. Okay. What else am I working on? Oh, that's what it is. Okay, so Coco Bear and I fly out this weekend to Michigan because that's where my shipping staff is. And we have a film crew coming that are gonna film us. It's from Inc. 5000. I don't know if you guys know who that is. It's like this big corporation. They pick all of the top companies in the US, and we made it to the list. Yay! So Makeup Geek is officially on the Inc. 5000 top new company in the US. So we get a film crew that's gonna come with us to Michigan. They're gonna interview me. They're gonna film all of my staff. So I'm really excited about that. I'll vlog the trip. So make sure you guys stay tuned for the next vlog so you could see the Inc. Magazine being there. And then we're going to Chicago right after that. Coco Bear's never been, and so I told him, like, you're coming this trip with me so that way you can go see Chicago too. So we're gonna do that next week. So lots of travel. So that's everything that's new for so far, but I wanted to do a what's in my purse tag just for fun because I haven't done it in a long time. And I was thinking, I was like, okay, am I too old to do this because I'm 34 now? Is it going to be kind of weird me doing it in my purse tag? And then I was like, you know what? I don't care. I'm going to do it anyways. So this is my new purse. You guys know I've been wearing this in all my fashion stuff. I love this purse. It is expensive, I'm not going to lie. Not gonna make out like, oh, it's, you know, oh, I have a lot of purses like this. This is actually worth the money, and please don't think I'm trying to boast at all. If I come across like that, please let me know. That's not my intention at all. But I feel like at this point in my life, I've worked so hard that I would like to have some nice things, especially something classic like a black purse. So I love this. This is a Balenciaga bag. And the reason I felt it was worth the splurge is the leather is so lightweight and soft, you guys. If you get one bag and you like the style, it is amazing. And it has so much room for all my stuff. Because you know Marlena likes to carry a lot of crap in her purse. And I travel a lot, so I need something lightweight. I love this. This is my purse. This is going with me to the grave. I will be wearing this till I'm 60 or 70 years old. But I love the black leather. I love the rocker studs. It's so mean because it has a little bit of edge to it, but it's still very classic of a bag. And it's so lightweight. It doesn't kill my back carrying it because it's just so light. So let me show you what's in there. Okay, so this isn't staged at all. You guys know me, I don't clean up my purse, so we'll figure out together what's going on with this. First off, I have tissues, no big deal. And then I have all of my stuff. I have this bag here that I keep all of my like toiletry items in, and then that way when I switch purses, I could just take this out and move it to the next bag. So I love this little bag here. I have deodorant, because of course no one wants to stink when they go to a business meeting, so I'm very paranoid about that, about smelling. I have all sorts of like cleanliness stuff in here, just so you know. Toothbrush, and you know, of course, toothpaste, because no one wants to have bad breath, or spinach sticking out of their teeth again when they're in a meeting, so that's why I carry that. Body spray, Bath & Body Beautiful Day. It smells like apples, it's really delicious. Hand sanitizer, because you gotta keep your hands clean when shaking people's hands. And again, in case your breath is raunchy, you have some gum, cinnamon flavor, because that's the best. Oh, these are the stevia tabs. Okay, so you guys know I travel a lot, and I try to not have sugar, but I want to have it as more organic as possible, so I try to use stevia. They have at Whole Foods this little tin can, and it has these little tablets of sweetener in there, and they're just these organic stevia, and you can drop them into your coffee and flavor it up. You don't have to worry about using like artificial sweeteners and stuff. I have my little tin too with my Tylenol, Dramamine, all of that great stuff in here. So again, when I travel, I need that. Lipstick by Tom Ford. Which one is this? Oh, Bruised Plum. You guys, this is such a beautiful color. It's kind of similar to what I'm wearing now. It's such a deep kind of violety color, and it's so wearable. You guys, it's beautiful for fall. If you want to splurge on any makeup item, you must get a Tom Ford lipstick. The texture is beautiful. They're very wearable because you can build up the color. They're not super, super pigmented, but they're not really sheer. They're just amazing. So trust me, if you get a lipstick, get the Tom Ford one. They're amazing. Lotion, hand lotion, because my hands get really dry when I fly. I have some rubber bands for my hair in case when I'm flying again. Oh, another Tom Ford lipstick. What's this one? Oh, violet. Oh, this is another kind of like deep one. This one's a little more purple. Isn't that pretty? It's like a fuchsia type color. It's gorgeous. I love Tom Ford lipstick. So that's pretty much all that's in here. A bunch of like random receipts and, oh, toothpicks. Yeah, that's exciting. Okay. Next that I have my, okay, grocery list. Apparently I needed green onions and tomatoes this week, so I did shopping for that. Keys. Oh, look, a pair of underwear in here. Oh, that's always nice. I can't believe I'm sharing that. I keep extra underwear in my purse sometimes just because you never know, like, if you need to keep it fresh. If I'm flying or say I get stranded, they still, you know, they just lost my suitcase. At least I have a fresh pair of undies to wear. You never know. I have a comb for my hair. What else is in here? Some peppermints, more paperwork, which I don't need to show you that. Oh, these are my probiotics that I use because you guys know I have stomach issues. Which I'll do another video update on that later because I'm going back to the Mayo Clinic. But anyways, I have to take probiotics, but you have to put them in the refrigerator a lot of the times. So I found a doctor in Berkeley that I'm trying to go see, and he has his own probiotics that you don't have to refrigerate. They're called Prescript Assist. I'll link to that below in the YouTube box, so check that out. But they work amazing. Everyone should be taking probiotics, especially if you have stomach problems, because they balance you out. And for me, these actually work really well. I've noticed a difference in my stomach since taking those, so I really highly recommend those. They work really great. I have my sunglasses, the ones that I'm wearing right now. What else is in here? Oh, my vlog camera. I have my vlog camera so I could tape behind the scenes stuff for you guys. Just random papers and stuff in here, and a pen. Okay. I have my sunglasses. A lot of you guys were asking about these because I wear them on Instagram. Which, you don't follow me on Instagram, you should. It's Makeup Geek TV. I post all of my pictures of me and Coco Bear, my travels, behind the scenes stuff of Makeup Geek. But I was wearing these aviators that you guys like, and I don't know what the names were. You guys were asking me. So I will type in the description box as well what the numbers are here. I don't know what to tell what they are. They're just the latest aviators from Chanel. So I really like those. They're really sturdy too. So that's pretty much what's in my makeup or my purse for you guys. So thank you guys again for your support, for watching my videos. I always appreciate it. So hopefully it was fun for you guys, and stay tuned for more vlogs and stuff. So I will get to show you what I'm working on with Makeup Geek, and you guys can give me input of what you would like to see so you can help me create the brand as well. So take care, you guys. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.